Happy day, Rajiv. Wondering if you can help me out, sir. I have a question regarding OnBase custom query, the configuration and utilization.
Hi, Tim. I'd be happy to help you with that. Let me share my screen. So custom queries allow you to easily retrieve documents that you may need to access frequently. To configure a custom query, we can begin by heading over to OnBase Configuration, Queries, and Custom Queries. Here, we can create a new custom query by naming it, then hitting the Create button. For this example, I'll create one titled AP Invoice Search. Next, we'll be prompted to assign user groups. For this custom query, I'll add AP user groups and manager. We'll then be presented with these options here. At the top, we can enter instructions for end users regarding the custom query. If this field is left blank, then the default instructions with the words search for, colon, and the custom query name will be displayed. Next, we can select which type of custom query we'd like to configure. For this example, we'll go with by document type, which will limit searches by the selected document types. We'll also select the restrict by rights checkbox so that the custom query only returns documents that users have the right to view. Under optional controls, we can select keyword edit fields to allow users to retrieve documents based on keyword values. Keyword select list can be checked to allow users to select a keyword value from a drop-down list. Value operators can be checked to display a drop-down list of operators, such as equal to, greater than, or less than. And binary operators can be checked to allow users to select the AND or logical operators. Next, under Advanced Options, we'll select Minimize Duplicate Documents so that our search only returns unique results. Then, under Usage, we can make this custom query available as a workflow filter, folder filter, or available on mobile devices. Under Retrieval Options, we'll select View Documents to display returned documents as open documents. And lastly, for date search options, we'll select date range to present a to and from date range search option. Then we're going to hit save. Up next, we'll hit the document type query button. Here, we can add as many document types as we want, but for this example, I'll only add the AP vendor invoice document type. In the retrieval keywords option, we can select which keyword types the end users can use to limit their search. Next, because we configured the custom query to have a date search option, we can also select a default date. We also have the option to change the icon for this custom query. Next, we can add columns to our search results by using the Display Columns option. We can also change the order and rename these columns. Next, we can use the Sort Columns option to display the search results in a pre-sorted order based on the values of the data in the columns. So, now that we're done configuring this custom query, let's head over to the Unity client to see how it can be utilized. On the top ribbon, let's select Custom Queries and navigate to the one we just configured. Note that this custom query can be added to your favorites, personal page, or home page, and that the instruction is set to the default search for. Now we can of course limit our search options we have here. I'll go ahead and put vendor number of 123. And there we go. Our search results are displayed.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. If you have a question that you would like answered on an upcoming question corner, please leave a comment below.